Hi everyone, so today I'm going to be doing a tutorial in real time. So I'm going to be painting with acrylics and I'm going to be painting some Conkers. In the UK, which is where I'm from, it's just starting to turn to autumn and there are beautiful brown shiny Conkers everywhere. So really, really nice to paint, really easy. And yeah, if you want to join me, then I'm just using a 20 by 20 centimeter canvas, but you could also use a canvas board or paper's fine as well. I'm going to be using acrylics. I quite like these Liquitex acrylics. They've got some really nice pre-made colours that make it quite easy to match. And I'm using a medium-sized round brush and then a very, very fine brush for adding in some detail. Hope you enjoy and let me know what you think. So the first colours I'm going to be using are, I'm going to use some burnt umber. So just pop a little bit of that on my palette. Oxazine purple. And to begin with, I'm going to do a bit of a wash outline. So I'm just doing a really rough outline just to get the basic shapes in. Okay, so that's my basic outline. And now I'm just going to block a little bit of colour just going to capture the lovely roundness of the Conkers, and then we'll build up a little bit of colour as we go. So starting off just with the really, really, really plain sort of dark brown. And then I'm just going to add in some more colours on the palette. So I'm going to do all the browns first. So I'm going to add some red oxide. and some raw umber. And a little bit of burnt sienna. Some raw sienna. Okay, so I'm going to make a start with my smaller paintbrush. Just map out some of the darker areas. So I'm just using the very dark umber just now. And when I look at the Conkers, I can see a little bit of like a mahogany purpley colour. So I'm just going to add in some purple. And because the paints are quite wet, so I can just blend it in and it won't look too much like bright purple. It'll just look like a little hint of purple. And then just do the same on this other one. And then just layer up some reddy brown. Again, a little bit of that purple just to create a nice bit of shadow at the base of the conker. Sometimes it's quite nice to, when you're adding shadow to an object, whatever colour the object is, it's quite nice to add in a dark version of the colour opposite. So if you're painting something orange, it's quite nice to do a bit of shadowing with a blue colour. Or if you're painting something green, it's quite nice to add a bit of red. It just really makes the colours stand out and provides a lot of contrast and makes the picture really, really bright and stand out. Okay, so I'm just going to pop in the lighter brown. I do like to use acrylics a little bit how I like to paint with oils. I like them very, very thick, and I'm not too worried about having them stand out from the page, having the paint stand out. As I say, I really do use them a little bit like oils in that way. You can use acrylics in a very watery way, so you can use acrylics in a very watery way. You can really water them down and create nice washes, but I do like to have that thickness in the paint and get quite a bit of texture. But it's always nice to have the option not to. Okay, so I'm just going to add in some unbleached titanium white. So this is going to be more for the paler areas on the conker. and a little bit of pure white. And just add some lighter colours here. Trying to get some of the detail from the Conkers. They've got lovely stripes. You can see some very, very pale stripes running through the Conkers. Combination of that really dark and that really red brown. Just so beautiful. So now time to add some green. So I'm going to be using Hooker's Green. And some brilliant yellow green. And I'll probably just add in a little bit of the brown as well, just to get the exact green that I want. And mix about 50-50 of those two. That looks quite nice. Okay, so now that I've got the base colour in, I'm just going to add in lots of browns and darker colours. The colouring is, you can see on the Conkers skin, it's very intricate and very almost spotty. So I'm just going to try and recreate that with the brush. And then you've got these spikes coming out. You might just need to wait for that to dry a little bit more. And while I do that, I'm just going to paint final conquer. just going to tone that down a little bit, just with more neutral colour, especially the main area, and then just put a little bit of shadowing in. For that to dry a little bit. So before I finish doing some detail to the Conkers, I'm actually just going to put a background wash on there just to give a nice finish. So this is just the purple I was using. It's a really subtle background. It's always a good idea to do a background first, because then you know exactly what you're doing and you can paint things in the foreground with a little bit more confidence, because you can go over the background, as it were, because the background's finished. But often I have no idea what I'm going to do as the background, so I tend to leave that till the end. So if you do the background last, it's a little bit annoying because you do have to work around the painting, which can mean that you have to redo certain areas, which is okay. One thing I haven't done yet is added any black. So I'm just going to use a really simple black and just pop in a little bit of shadowing and a little bit of definition as well. So thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial and I hope you've enjoyed painting with me. And if you did like this video, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks. See you next time.